Welcome to the Overlook Hotel. On this side, we have an elm tree, and on this side, we have a pine tree. If you look in front of you, we have a mountain. And in the middle of this mountain, we have a small, quaint hotel with the father of a family who's about to go crazy and try to kill his wife and son. His son happens to be able to talk to his hand who can see the future and the past. Also in this hotel, we have many fun attractions like the ghosts of the dead twins that the old caretaker killed viciously and more. Enjoy your stay.
The Shining by Stephen King.
Steven.
Oh. Air table. Jack, come on in. Welcome to the Overlook Hotel. It's very nice to meet you.
Nice to see you too. Man, it sure was a long drive up here, but I can't wait to start being the caretaker of this place.
Yeah, it's not a very demanding job, except for the tremendous sense of isolation.
That's exactly what I'm looking for. 5 months of peace and quiet is just what I need to finish my book.
That's very good, Jack, because for some people, solitude and isolation can be a problem.
My family's gonna have a great time. I'm sure they'll just love it.
Great. Oh, and if you needed to know it for any plot-specific reason, Charles Grady used to be the caretaker of this place till he ran amok during the winter and killed his wife and twin daughters with an axe and then offed himself.
The Shining. We already said that.
Tony, do you think Dad is gonna get the job?
Yeah, he did. He's gonna phone Wendy up any minute now to tell her.
Hello?
Honey, I got the job.
Wow, you are good. How did you know that was gonna happen?
1 month later.
Jack, nice to see you again. Hope you haven't been waiting too long.
Of course not. We actually had time to grab a bite to eat.
That's good. Is your family still having a look around?
Yeah, I think they're still in the kitchen.
I've seen this place before. Crazy stuff, man. It'll leave a kid messed up.
Ha! I'm howling. My grandma, she called it the Shine. And for a long time, I thought it was just the two of us that had the Shine.
Oh.
To us. The Shine makes you see things that aren't there. Once were.
Is that why I see room 237? Mr. Halloran, what's in room 237?
No! You stay out of there, you understand? You just stay out!
I'm seven. I'm obviously not gonna stay out.
The Shining.
Seriously?
What? Another month later.
Come play with us, Danny.
Come play.
Who are you?
Ah, we're twins, obviously.
Can't you see the resemblance?
Oh, that is terrifying!
Okay, your lovely tour guide is back again. Remember when I said the father of this family is gonna go crazy? Well, here, he walks into a bar where he thinks he sees people, but they're really just ghosts. One of the ghosts he meets is Charles Grady. That's the guy who killed his family with an axe. Those are his daughters.
Your bar!
Hey there, Lloyd. Things are a little slow today, huh?
What'll it be?
I'll be shot bourbon.
Is everything all right, Mr. Torrance?
I just probably feel that wife upstairs.
Women! Can't live with them, can't live without them.
Very good words of wisdom, boy.
Shh. Ooh, sorry, sir. I didn't mean to spill that all over you.
Oh, it's fine. I guess I have plenty of jackets.
I guess I'll get new glasses.
Here, I'll take you to the gentleman's room so we can get you cleaned up.
Right.
Oh, look, the gentleman's room.
So, what do they call you around here, Jeezy?
Oh, Grady, sir. Charles Grady.
Haven't I heard that name before?
No, I don't believe so, sir. I would remember.
Charles Grady, I remember now. You were the guy that ran amok in this hotel and killed his wife and two daughters with an axe, and then you killed yourself, right?
I'm sorry, sir. I have no recollection of that at all.
Hmm.
Did you know, sir, that your son has a very special talent? So great, in fact, I don't think he really quite grasped the situation here. He's trying to use his very talent against your will.
Well, he is a very willful boy.
Yes, he is a very willful boy. Very naughty boy, if I may be so bold.
It's his mother. She interferes.
Perhaps they need a good talking to. Perhaps a bit more. My daughter, sir, when we first came to the Overlook Hotel, didn't care for as much. But then I corrected them. And when their mother tried to interfere, I corrected her.
Jack is writing his book now.
Come on, Danny, let's go play. Tag, the loser has to do the dishes.
You'll have to do the dishes, Mrs. Torrance.
Let's just take the rest of this walking, huh, Danny? You win. Dad, you would never hurt Mommy or me, would you?
Of course not. Did your mother tell you that?
No, Dad.
Listen to me. I love you more than anything else in the whole wide world, and I'd never do anything to hurt you. Never.
Wednesday.
Jack? Hon, what's wrong, Jack?
I had a dream where I killed you and Danny and then chopped you up into little pieces.
Oh! Okay. You're not crazy. You're fine. I'm gonna ignore that and just walk this way.
Thursday.
I'm gonna take a look at Jack's book. All work and no play make Jack a dull boy. All work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
I wrote it a lot because I'm crazy.
All work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. Ooh. All work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
Do you like it? Wendy, darling, love of my life, I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just gonna bash your brains in.
Baseball bat so conveniently placed.
Oh, Danny, I'm so glad you're here. We gotta get away. This man.
Red Room! Red Room! Red Room!
Danny, what's wrong?
Room! Red Room! Red Room!
Danny, hon, are you?
Danny isn't here, Mrs. Torrance.
Wendy, I'm home. Little pigs, let me come in.
Where have I heard that before?
That's from one of those books you used to read me.
Oh, that's right. Wait, why are you still here?
I was demented, now I'm not. You were supposed to push me out a window, but you skipped that part.
Oh, that's right.
Can you guys just show up and let me say my line?
Oh, sure, fine, go for it.
Not by the hairs on your chinny chin chin, then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in.
Jack, hun, I feel like you could have been just like a bit more creative.
Okay, fine. How about this? Here's Johnny!
Better, less vogue, and where'd you get the Johnny?
Well, actually, the Johnny part comes from during the Tonight Show with Eric McMahon. He would always say, "Here's Johnny," introducing Johnny Carson as the new Where'd they go? That's the problem with mansplaining.
Anybody here? I brought my snow cat so you guys can get away from your crazy husband.
I'm not crazy! Danny, where are you? I want to play a game called the Quiet Game forever.
Oh, Danny, I'm so glad you're here. We gotta get away. I found the snow cat and we can just leave, okay?
Okay, Mom. Hello again, everybody. As for the ending, I don't really know either. Hope you enjoyed your stay.
Yes, I think.